Hey everybody, it's Wendy with loveandstampin.com. Today I'm going to make a slimline card and I'm using the Coming Home Bundle. And I've got my color splash combo, which is Granny Apple Green, Poppy Parade, Pool Party, and Flirty Flamingo. So for the slimline, I cut this at 7 inches, is 7 inches by 8.5. So you score it at 3.5 inches, and you're gonna get the perfect slimline approach. So this is just a random piece of cardstock. It is 8.5 inches wide. And the first thing I'm doing is lining up this hillside. And then I'm gonna carefully remove it and align up the second hillside right next to it to cut it all the way through. So what I did is I just kind of felt my way around here to make sure that my cutting blade was lining up with the cut line that already existed. So now I'm going to pop this back in my Stampin' Cut! Embossing machine and I'm going to run it through again. So this will cut my whole mountain slopey hill scene, and that's it, done. Isn't that cool? So now I have this whole big long piece to go on my slimline card. So the next step is coloring the trees. I want the trees to obviously be green, and I'm trying to stay with my color splash, so I'm going to use Granny Apple Green ink to ink blend these trees and get them the color that I want them to be. And then we are gonna finish assembling the card. So we're gonna kind of jump back and forth between our chit chat, story time, and card making today. The video is sped up, and I do want to mention that all the products that you see me using are listed below the video. And if you have any questions about any of the items I'm using or questions about the technique or the card or anything, you can always drop it in the comments below the video. Okay, so a little story time. One of the last videos that we had together, I told you and shared with you about my husband taking a week off of her vacation and participating in a fishing derby. So for those who might not live in the U.S. or are possibly unfamiliar, a fishing derby is basically when you go fishing for maybe a certain type of fish, and it's basically, you know, the winner catches the biggest fish. In this case, it is the winner is the one that catches the biggest fish, but you have 3 tries. So you get to catch 3 fish. Well, you can catch as many fish as you want, but you get to turn in 3 fish. So the particular type of fish my husband is fishing for is called catfish, and it is a catfish derby, and he is in the lead right now as of this video. So yeah, he's doing really good. He's caught some really big fish and turned him in, and so he's in the lead, and the winner gets $1,000, and he's already made up his mind that if he wins, he is going to donate that money to a lady who has been recently diagnosed with pancreatic cancer that works at the bait shop near where he fishes. So he just feels for her. She's fairly young. She's 48, and so that's what he wants to do with the winnings. So, yeah, I hope he wins, because I think that that's a very noble, sweet, wonderful, kind thing to do. Really quick, back to the card. I am coloring the door and the roof Poppy Parade, but I am cheating a little. I am using real red here to lay down an even darker layer than the dark Poppy Parade. So then I'm going to layer in all my Poppy Parade, and it will kind of give a little bit of dimension and individuality to these roof slats, I guess we're going to call them. I don't know. They're not really shingles. And then we're going to go in with Pool Party to color the windows. And I just decided to keep the chimney red also. And then, of course, the granny apple green for the trees. And the little buggy car will be blue. Now, normally I would color a tree trunk brown. And I would probably change up some of the colors on these houses. But I wanted to keep my color splash theme going. So that is why you're going to see that this is kind of an interesting little color choice, combo choice here for some of these things. Okay, so that's what's happening with our family. Basically, Macy and I have spent a ton of time on our own this week doing stuff, which has been great. I always enjoy bonding time with her. We can watch, you know, chick flicks and that kind of stuff that we don't normally watch when dad is around. There has been a lot of Gilmore Girls on the TV. My mom is also staying with us right now, so she had never seen Gilmore Girls, which I don't even understand. I do not even understand. But she has managed, since she's been staying with us, to watch all 7 seasons of the Gilmore Girls and the follow-up miniseries. So she's watched it all. And so that's been fun too, to watch it with somebody for the first time. There's no die cut for that bigger tree, so I just fuzzy cut it out. Okay, other news. Let's see, what else is happening? Kiddo is still in school 1 day a week, and that is going well.
There
is something new. I'm getting kittens tomorrow. So for those of you who watch, you know I'm a dog person, love dogs, not a big cat fan. However, cats are extremely useful. We live pretty rural, so occasionally we can have problems with rats and mice, like wood rats, not like gross city rats, but like wood rats, which all rats are gross, let's just be real. Here, I just wanted to add a little bit of texture and color to the edge of the top of this card, and then I'm going to stamp the little snowflakes all over it. So, you know, if you are watching this and you're like, well, why did she do that? It doesn't look like there's anything on there. There really is something on there. It's just kind of hard to see in the video and in the photos, honestly. I'm going to pick up 2 kittens tomorrow. They've been spayed and neutered, and they are ready to be picked up and have a new forever home. And because we're getting them through the barn cat program, these cats are semi-feral. So they're basically, these are the types of cats that would generally just get euthanized. But they have a special program where I live where you can adopt feral cats for the purposes of having them work for you, like be mousers, live in your barn, that kind of thing. So that's essentially what we're going to do. We've done this once before and it did not go well. We did this before and one of the cats within 4 months had got leukemia and died. And then the other cat just laid around and meowed constantly because it was sad that it lost its sister. And we ended up rehoming it because it was making me a crazy person. It would not stop crying. So I felt bad for it, but I felt like it just needed a change of venue because it associated our home with its sister. And it was so sad. So we actually rehomed it to another home that ended up taking pretty good care of it for a while, and then it ended up going to the neighbor's house because I think it got a little bit more attention and food at the neighbor's. It's kind of a sad story, and please don't leave me any hate comments because we did our best. But you have to understand, these cats are not like, they're feral, so it's not like dealing with like your sweet lovey little house cat. They're wild, they can be mean, and so the other option for these types of cats is basically to be euthanized, which sucks also. So we are going to adopt 2 7-month-old kittens, and they apparently are like friendly enough to touch and be around, but not necessarily like a house cat, which I think is going to be perfect. None of our dogs really care about cats. I mean, Truby tries to play with them. She's a little bit scared of them, so she does have a tendency to stand and just bark at them. And then our other two dogs are just little, so they're just afraid of them. The cats scare them. So I don't foresee any problems with any of that. I think it'll be completely fine. And then hopefully they are going to take care of our rodent issue because, ew, gross, ew. So I don't want rodents hanging around. I would rather them be lunch for the cats. So if you have ideas for cat names, I would love to hear them. I was thinking of naming them after like TV cats. Like if the one is a boy, I don't even know if they're like male, female, two females, two males. I'm not sure. I don't know what they look like because there's this whole thing with COVID where you can't like I wanted to go today and look at all the kittens. You can't do that. You have to call, make an appointment, and then they tell you like, okay, be here at this time. What kind of car do you drive? We'll meet you at the gate. We'll let you in. We'll lock the gate behind you. So there's no, like, you're not allowed to just go in and hang out and like look around at all the animals. So I had to basically pick over the phone what we wanted. And that was weird. So I don't really know what we're getting. I just was like two cats that are not tiny. You know, I didn't want little bitty ones because then I would have to do the litter box and keep them inside. And then they kind of can come become house cats. And I really didn't want that. I don't do litter boxes. They gross me out. So, yeah. So that's the scoop with all of that. So tomorrow we're going to go pick them up. And I guess probably we'll decide names after we see them because I feel like you have to see them first to like really make the decision on what their names are going to be. And then we'll see how it goes when we get them home. I'm just hoping they hang around and they stay healthy and they get nice and fat on rodents. I mean, we're going to feed them too. I'm going to stop and pick up some cat food so that I can have cat food out for them. But I really don't want to overfeed them because then they won't be mousers. So there's like a happy medium. I grew up on property where we had cats off and on, and we always like fed them, but not a lot because then they tend to not hunt as much. So, or at least that was our experience when we were kids. Maybe there's somebody out there watching this who is a cat expert and you're going to tell me differently. And that's fine. Also, it has been my experience that if you really want them to be good hunters, you can't overfeed. Okay. This is my finished card. Isn't it cute? And then all I had left to do was add a little bit of crystal accents. I can't remember what it's called. It's linked below the video, but I wanted to add that to the big windows on the main house. And then I thought about adding it to like the windows on the car and the tires and everything, but I don't know if I was either lazy or I just opted out. I don't know. But I've been using this crystal effect stuff a lot lately. I just really love it. I love the pen because the little squeeze tube, because it fits nicely in my hand and I feel like I have a lot of control with it. So it's a product that I'm really happy with. I really, really like it. So if you need one, it's linked below the video. You can pick one up. Yeah, that's about it, guys. There's not a lot happening other than I've got work-wise. I'm working on getting club kits ready to mail. Club is closing on October 20th. So if you haven't already taken advantage and signed up for the 1 month trial, there is a link below the video where you can do that. And then, yeah, that's it. That's what's going on. Just hanging out, waiting for it to cool off a little. It's still in the 90s here in California. So we haven't really had much of a fall yet. few brisk mornings, but mostly warm. And there's my card. Isn't that awesome? I love it. I love it. If you want to see another video from me, click either one you see here. Shop with me at shoploveandstampin.com. And if you have any questions for me, comments, cat names, or ideas for me to make a future video, drop it in the comments below this video. I always love hearing from you. Talk to you soon.